is 32-time PBA Tour title winner Norm Duke.
Watching the bowling this morning. Some guys are real happy. Some guys aren't very happy at all.
What kind of guy are you?
Kind of a mid-to-top hat. But it's fun watching all the unhappy ones. We get a kick out of that, even though we feel sorry for him.
Duke's destiny in qualifying was never really in doubt. A picture of consistency through the 14 games. Duke would ultimately qualify third. But the one having the most success in qualifying this day wasn't a Norm Duke or a Chris Barnes or even a Wes Mallott. That honor would go to a 23-year-old non-exempt player from Cheektowaga, New York, named Ryan Simonelli.
Hi, Mom.
Simonelli is a pro, but one who had to earn his way into qualifying for the Cheetah Championship through what's known as a TQR, a tournament qualifying round that consists of 7 games. He dazzled in that event, besting nearly 100 other hopefuls, and is repeating his performance here in Cheetah qualifying against the best bowlers in the world. Throwing an old-school urethane ball, Simonelli dominated qualifying, finishing nearly 90 pins ahead of Mallott, Duke, and PBA veteran Jack Jurek.
I'm definitely on cloud nine right now. I came in with some confidence because of the urethane ball that came out. And it's allowed me to stay in my comfort zone, and it's really, really been successful for me. So far, there's been enough friction out there for it. Different grip pressures and different ball speeds have been a key. But as long as I can get that ball to the pocket, I'm going to be throwing it.
Simonelli is clearly the star of the qualifying rounds, but match play awaits. Will his good fortune continue? 7 PBA Tour titles up for grabs at the inaugural $2.1 million PBA World Series of Bowling here in Detroit. A relative unknown named Ryan Simonelli has surprised everyone, capturing the number one seed in this tournament with a dominant performance in qualifying. Simonelli, along with Wes Mallott, Norm Duke, and Jack Jurek, each receive a bye in the round of 28 and advance directly to the round of 16.
That was big to me because the best of 7, you know, those guys, they really know how to break lanes down. They're really smart. And an extra match bye is really helpful to an up-and-comer like
me. Mika isn't the only native of Finland competing in the Cheetah round of 28. Asku Palerma shares the same serious demeanor as his fellow countrymen. But that's where the similarities end. Asku throws two-handed, like Australian sensation Jason Belmonte. But even though they have the same style, Asku was overshadowed by Belmonte as a media darling last season.
Of course, it's a little bit depressing to see. We've been around the same time. We won about the same amount of things. He just won one in here and was here for the year, so he got the attention because the media is bigger here. But I'm here, so we'll see what happens.
Ryan Simonelli would square off with his friend Ryan Schaefer, who rolled a perfect game and has come from behind win over Thomas Newell in the previous round. But even though Schaefer was able to win a one-ball roll-off in Game 5, he was ultimately unable to stop Simonelli, who took the match 4-2. Making the trip in from Cheektowaga, New York, to see his son win yet again is Angelo Simonelli, a dad who has nurtured Ryan's talent from childhood.
He used to stay up and he couldn't sleep some nights, just thinking about why I wasn't succeeding or I wasn't to my full potential. And throwing that urethane ball, that was one of his ideas.
This bowling ball was my godsend. There's no question about it. And of course, at first he didn't like it because it went too straight. He told me it's backing up. I go, yeah, that's right. It's backing up. Now square up and learn how to use it.
He's a great dad. You know, I couldn't ask for better parents. And they've always wanted what I've wanted for myself. And they probably wanted it more than I did. They did everything in their power to get me everywhere I needed to be. And for that, I'll forever be appreciative.